All right, everybody. Hopefully you guys are loving your first 2 days. So I always do a live video in Q&A today for a few reasons. The first reason is that low carb day is a little tricky. As you guys have noticed, I'm sure you're like, what did I get myself into with these high fats? Aren't we supposed to be losing fat? Why is she making me eat all this fat? So this is what we are definitely going to be chatting through. So low carb days, you always, always, always have three rules that you have to follow. The first rule is that you have to keep your carbs low. So that is less than 50 grams of net carbs. And again, you guys, net carbs are your total carbs minus your fiber that gives you your net carbs. So that's rule number one on low carb days. Keep those carbs low, less than 50 grams of net carbs. Second rule then is to keep your protein right where it's at. If you look at your regular day in MyFitnessPal, you want to hit that protein goal. So for example, my protein goal daily is 96 grams. So even on a low carb day, I still want to hit that 96 grams of protein. So again, let's rewind. Number one is keep those carbs low, less than 50 grams. If you are a breastfeeding mom though, you can actually keep yours less than 100 grams of net carbs. That's what I want you guys to do. If you just, as long as, until your supply is established or until you know that your supply isn't going to be affected. I personally breastfed for a full year to a T, 50 grams or less. So I'm definitely not saying you can't do the 50 grams. I want you guys to like kind of play it by ear, listen to your body, see what your body needs, and then adjust accordingly. And then number two is you're going to keep your protein goal the same. So as a normal day, your protein goal is always going to stay the same except for on those low macro days where everything's decreased by 25%. Then the third thing is that you have to increase those fats. So we are in a deficit because we have decreased our carbs significantly. So we have to make up for that somehow, because I do not want you guys under eating. That is the last thing that I want for you all. So we have to make that up somehow. So we make that up in consuming higher amounts of fat. Now, the reason why we do that, and I'm not sure if I explained this to you all before, but the reason why we increase our fat rather than our protein is because when we are doing these low carb days, our body has totally burned through that glycogen. So our body is relying on those fat stores. It's relying on any readily available fat for fuel. So it's not going to tap into those protein stores. It would rather burn up that fat. So that's why we want to make sure that we are eating an excess of fat, because whatever we consume in healthy fats will get burnt up as fuel or as energy for those high intensity interval trainings, for that sprint workout, for that Tabata workout, those really good cardio workouts that we do on Mondays and Tuesdays. So that's the reason as well that we always want to keep those two low carb days paired together. So you guys, this is another thing that comes up a lot within the first week. This is a question I get a lot, is my schedule doesn't totally work the same every single week. Am I able to switch things up? Yes, you are 100% able to switch up anything as long as you keep your nutrition paired with your workouts and you keep your two low carb days back to back. So that's really important for the fat burning purposes. That way we have totally depleted our glycogen stores, and then we are able to continuously burn fat for fuel instead of burn through our glycogen stores. So that hopefully is helpful for you guys. Just make sure you keep your nutrition paired. And when I say nutrition paired with your workout, I literally mean, so if Friday is typically a rest day, instead of doing a rest day on Friday, if you have, like I think Cassie was asking me before, she's got like a wedding to go to on Friday and she wants to have some treats and she's going to be eating later. So maybe it's a good idea to then swap your Saturday and your Friday. So now she'll be doing her leg day on Friday, which also means that she can consume those extra calories, those extra macros, those extra treats, because she's done leg day, and that's going to be able to burn 3 to 4 times more than if she was doing a rest day. So make sure you keep those paired together so that it all works together. Throughout this video, you guys, those of you who are actually on here, I don't know if you see the chat feature down at the bottom. If you have a question that pops up, ask it in the chat feature. I'll see that pop up on the side. So let me just write on there, here is the chat feature. So that way you guys can see where the chat feature is. And if you guys have any questions while I'm going through this, just ask away. That's the point of this. I want to make sure you guys are super set up. What I'm doing right now is basically just going through and talking about some of the most common questions I get asked in the first week. So Cassie asked, can you explain low macro? Is it basically 25% less of everything, so less calories fat? Yes, absolutely. So the cool thing about macros is that your macros, whatever MyFitnessPal has allotted you, if you hit your macros to a T, you will also hit your calories to a T. So while I don't want you guys focusing on calories, it is something to be said that they equal the exact amount of macros that MyFitnessPal has given you for your goals. So they do kind of go hand in hand, but the important thing is that I want to make sure you guys are getting the right amounts of macros instead of looking at calories as a whole. So I hope that makes sense to everybody. But yes, Cassie, on those low macro days, we decrease everything by 25%. So if we're decreasing all of our macros by 25%, that also means we are decreasing that calorie number by 25%. And so in order to do that, we will decrease our carbs by 25%, our protein by 25%, and our fats by 25%. So for example, if you are allotted 200 grams of carbs a day, then you will now be, your goal will now be 150 grams of carbs. If you are allotted 100 grams of protein a day, you are now able to eat 75%. Or 75 grams of protein. Something that seems really, really simple, but kind of is something that you would not think of. And it took me a while to think of this myself, but one way that I make sure that I do this, because a lot of people have trouble with low macro days for whatever reason, just figuring out what to eat and how to eat less. So what I usually do is I eat the exact same thing as I would on a regular macro day. I literally just eat 25% less of my food. So I don't like cut out a meal throughout the day. I don't, like try to limit my, like my different meals that I have. I usually eat at the same time. I just eat 25% less than I would on a regular day. So I hope that makes sense. Like typically for me, if I'm home, I'll do like eggs first thing in the morning. So instead of having like, instead of eating my, I usually have one real egg and then two egg whites. Instead of eating all of that, I'll leave like 25% on my plate and save it for the next day. If that makes sense, that helps me. That way I can like literally see, okay, I'm literally eating 25% less. If that works for you, I hope that helps. If not, just leave it. But always definitely pre-plan in MyFitnessPal. Like you guys, that's my number one thing that I will tell you to be successful with your macros is that you have to pre-plan into MyFitnessPal, because what you don't want is that you start off the day not having a plan, and then you're halfway through the day and you realize you've already hit your carb goals, but you have a ton of fat that you need to get in there somehow, or you have a ton, or if you've already hit your fat goals, but you have a ton of protein you need to get, because usually those are pretty simultaneous where they're hand in hand. So make sure you're really planning. Speaking of MyFitnessPal, there are two things I want to share with you guys that are features that it took me like the longest time to figure out they were there, which is so funny to me that I'm a coach and I literally had no idea these features were on there until like six months into my coaching. But if you are looking at your screen, there are two little icons in the top right. One of them is a barcode and one of them is a pin drop. The barcode is literally like you can pick up your phone, grab your food, the label on your food, and scan the barcode, and it uploads immediately into your MyFitnessPal. It is so easy, so simple. It really helps with making sure that you get the exact right food, because I know like there's a million different sausages out there. There's a million different types of eggs out there. But if you actually scan the product that you bought, then MyFitnessPal uploads it immediately, and then you can choose your portion. And then the thing next to that, the little pin drop, that is actually a restaurant locator. So if you are, say you're out to lunch or you're out to dinner, or you want to know if maybe there is, like you're out to dinner and you're having trouble figuring out how to track it. So the best thing you can do then is press that, see if their menu is in MyFitnessPal. If it is, then you can scroll through their menu and click on that item and it will upload. So for example, Chipotle is in MyFitnessPal. So if you go to Chipotle, you can click on your little pin drop and then you can literally make your own burrito or your own burrito bowl, whatever you get. And that way you can see right there how many macros is in it. And it's super simple for you. You don't have to guess. So not all restaurants have that, but there are definitely a lot that do. So make sure you just check that because I think it's helpful. All right, Kathleen asked a question. How do you find your goals on MyFitnessPal and ceiling daily amount and percentage? But I'm wondering daily grams, like you mentioned. Okay, so Kathleen, what I want you to do is go into MyFitnessPal. I wonder if I could do this. It's going to look backwards if I try to show you. So you'll go into MyFitnessPal, and then what you'll do is you'll click on the top where it says the calories for the day. That's usually like the main page when you log in. So mine's going to look backwards to you, plus my screen is cracked. But you'll see right there, you can click there. And then that's where you will upload all of your stuff. If you click on there again, you can see the middle button. Whoops, someone's trying to do something. You can see right there is nutrients. So then it will show you. It's not really great at showing you guys because my screen is so damaged. But it will show you your goals, your what you have left, and your total. So Kathleen, the nutrients tab, that's what that is going to be so helpful for you throughout the day. That's really what I want you all to focus on is the nutrients tab. The macros tab, which is the tab that shows your pie chart, is really just for me. It's so that I can run through at the end of the day and see your percentages and your grams really quickly, because for me, it's easier to get through all of you and at the same time if I have that macro chart with the small grams, rather than me trying to like decipher what you actually did. So I like having the macro chart uploaded, but what I want you to focus on is the nutrient tab throughout the day, because then that's what really shows you like your total, what you've eaten and what you have left or what you're over. And then that's how you can really adjust to see if you're right on your calories or your goals or not. And then you said you can't find the pin drop. So the pin drop then is when you are uploading food. So go back into your diary, which I think, yeah, your diary is what it's called. So there's like the little buttons on the bottom. If you click on your diary, that will take you to like today's food, whatever you're putting in. And then if you just go to any of these and press add food, you'll see these two icons up at the top. This one right here is the pin drop, and you can click on that and it will populate restaurants by me. So I'm actually at Starbucks right now because my husband volunteered to put the kids to bed. So like Jimmy John's is right next to me, McAllister's is right next to me, and you can see all of these places have their menu uploaded into MyFitnessPal. So that's how you can do that. It's super simple, and it's like the coolest little secret trick that I never knew was on there. Okay, good. Glad you found it, Kathleen. Okay, Kara said you have to go to add. Okay, good. Yep, Kara. Thank you so much for clarifying that. Perfect. Okay. Let me think of something else. Okay, here's another question that comes up a lot within the first couple weeks is during your fast, what will break your fast? And so simply put, really do your best to stick to water during your fast. You can have black coffee. You can also, this is like the catch 22, and you have to be very careful with this, which is why I don't love telling you all this, because it kind of muddies the waters a little bit. You can actually have consume less than 50 calories of whole foods and not break your fast. Anything over 50 calories will break your fast, but here's the tricky part of that is it has to be a whole food and it has to be something that will not raise your blood sugar. And so, for example, those are things that would break your fast and that have like what I would call a high glycemic index, which is something that will raise your blood sugar. Those are things like those flavored waters. Mio has sucralose in it. It has aspartame in it, which is an artificial sweetener. It has maltodextrin in it. So those are all artificial sweeteners that will raise your blood sugar. So although it's less than 50 calories, it can still raise your blood sugar. So that's why I'm saying you guys really stick to those whole foods and really just try to stick to water, herbal teas, coffee. You can add almond milk to your black coffee because unsweetened almond milk is a raw, natural, whole food because it's simply almonds. And the really cool thing about that is about a cup is 30 calories. So for those of you who love coffee and can't do black coffee, you can definitely add that. I will also say there is like one sneaky way to get around not having any sweetener during your fast, and that is to have Truvia or Stevia, because those are natural sweeteners that do not elicit an insulin response, which actually raises your blood sugar. And so your blood sugar gets raised, your body elicits an insulin response to get that sugar out of your bloodstream. So that's kind of like a little bit more higher level, but you can have BCAAs, natural BCAAs. So Mom Sanity is the only brand that I know of that has natural sweeteners. So if you see Stevia, that's okay. It won't raise your blood sugar or elicit an insulin response. So you can do Mom Sanity BCAAs. That is truly the only BCAA I have found that doesn't have the other artificial sweeteners in it that will raise your blood sugar and elicit an insulin response. If you have a question about something that you are consuming and you want to know if it will break your fast or not, take a picture of the ingredients and post it on our page and tag me. I will be more than happy to look through the ingredients for you guys and let you know if it's a yes or a no. The other things that you can have during your fast is if you want a stick of gum, eat your stick of gum. Like, you're not gonna ruin your fat loss goals by chewing a stick of gum. Like, you all, we are not gonna even go down that course because that is like way too intense for me. And if you can't eat gum and lose weight, then there's a bigger issue going on. So let's just like be very clear with that. It's okay to eat gum. Also, like, that's not realistic long-term to never chew gum. So, like, if you can't, like, this is truly meant to be super sustainable. It's meant to be a lifestyle. So if you guys are thinking in your head, like, I could never not eat gum again, like, what? There's never anything that's off limits. Like, for those of you actually who are asking me this, you guys, I still eat ice cream every single Saturday, like, without a doubt. And the reason why is because it's, like, it's controlled, it's very mindful, and we get to do those high workouts, that high activity weight training workout on Saturday that's going to help us burn 3 to 4 times more calories. So we get those discretionary calories, but always make sure it fits into your macros for the day. So for me, Graters, if you guys are from Cincinnati, you know that Graters is the best ice cream in the planet. And so Graters is my jam. That's what we do every Saturday. But I always put my Graters in there first, and then I work my day around the rest of, I work my day around my Graters so that I can make sure I have that, but then I still am staying within my macros. So I hope that makes sense to you. Like, Saturdays aren't like a day that you just go overboard and eat all the things. It's still intentional. It's still mindful. Yes, French fries. You can do French fries. Just be smart about them. Do them on Saturday when you know your body is a fat-burning machine, and plan them into your MyFitnessPal. Totally doable, 100% okay. So that's kind of my point of this, is this is definitely a program where I want you eating whole foods. I want you really being mindful of what you're eating, how much you're eating, all of that stuff. But I don't want you to think that you can never eat anything again that you like. So that's just, we'll leave it at that. I was going to say one last thing that I have a question come up a lot, and it crossed my mind, and now I have forgotten all about it again. Should have written it down. Okay, you guys. So tomorrow then, Wednesday, is going to be a regular macro day. So what you are going to want to do is follow your MyFitnessPal goals to a T. So whatever MyFitnessPal has allotted for you, for your proteins, your fats, and your carbs, that's what you're going to do. So tomorrow your pie chart should look really pretty. Half of it should be blue with your carbs, and then the other half should be green and red with your proteins and your fats. You guys, I am just so, so excited for all of you. You guys are going to rock this. I just like cannot tell you how awesome you all have been already. Your engagement in our group, your supportiveness, like you guys are already like loving on each other, which makes me super, super happy. So I cannot wait for these next 6 weeks, and I can't wait to see how awesome all of you do. You guys are going to absolutely crush this, and it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to have some contests coming up. If you guys know me, you know I'm competitive. You know I like to give away free things, and we're going to have some fun. So don't forget to have fun throughout this process too, because this should not make you stressed. It should not make you anxious. It should not make you hungry. So make sure that you guys have fun along the process, and we will all just be super successful together. Kathleen, yes, carbs are going to be super high tomorrow. It's a refeed day. Eat all the fruit that you want and have lots of fun. All right, you all. Okay, Kayla has one last question. On regular macro days and low macro days, do we calculate net carbs? Good question. No, we don't need to do net carbs on regular macro days or low macro days, only on those low carb days. So that was a great question. So good one. Don't need to worry about that for tomorrow. One less thing to worry about. So tomorrow's an easy day. According to my fitness pal, just do what it tells you to do and you'll be golden. Okay, you guys, if you have questions on this or something pops up later on, make sure you comment in your Facebook group. And you guys, do not forget to tag me. I have 90 of you going through this round. So if you guys want me to see something really quick, you guys have to tag me. And then the other thing I'm going to tell you guys is that Thursdays are always my days home with my kiddos. So I will only get around to you guys in the very early morning and at night. Throughout the day, there's literally just no time for me to check in with that many of you. So if there's something super urgent, tag me, or just make sure that you like make it a separate post and tag me in it. That way I can see it super quick, respond to you, and then pop back off. But just want to make that expectation known so that you guys aren't like sitting around waiting for me on Thursdays like, where is she? Why isn't she checking in? So you guys have a great evening, and I'm just so excited for all of you. I can't wait, and I will talk to you all later. All right. Love you, ladies.